I'm making bullets. I'm making bullets. Ah, son of a bitch. Old man Taylor, welcome back to the reloading bench. What have I done today? Well, I've got another case stuck in a die. Different type of die. This is the threaded extractor with the decap pin attached. I've made a video prior on the Lee system and how to get that out. If I can figure it out, click that button if you've got a Lee die instead. This is a more conventional setup. A lot of different brands are using this threaded decap pin. So I can't take my hammer to the extractor. I will definitely destroy that. So with a case stuck in this system, there's a different kit that we're going to use today. It's going to be the RCBS extractor kit. Everybody makes one. Lee, Lyman, Redding, there's a version of this. They're all very similar. Doesn't have to be specific to the brand of the die. The other things we're going to need when we're working through this, we're going to need a drill. Any type of drill, electric, low power, doesn't have to be anything fancy. We're going to need a way to turn a tap. An adjustable wrench works very well for that. But if I do have a tap handle, that works a little bit better. And the kit is going to come with a 3/16, at least the RCBS version, that fits the top of the bolt. I may want a longer handle or a way to cheat that short Allen, as there's a significant amount of force involved. All right, so the first thing I want to do is invert this die and get the case sticking up so that I can work on it. Either that, or I could mount that in my vise. That's also a very viable option. A lot of folks don't have a vise, so I wanted to show this way, demonstrate this version. All right, I'm going to move some cameras, get some real tight shots here, and I'll see you over there. What we're going to be doing, of course, is working this end, and I've got a decap pin in the way. So I've got to roll the decap pin out. Now, you've already figured out your expander is stuck inside the case, and this isn't coming out. And that's okay, but all I need to do is lower it enough so that my tools, when I'm working through, you know, the top edge of this case, doesn't impact the my decap pin. Well, and if it does, it's, you know, no big deal. I'm probably going to destroy the pin, but I can roll that down. And now, you know, you can't see it, but it's probably somewhere down here. That gives me plenty of room to drill and tap on this end. So the next thing we want to do is drill and tap. So I'm simply going to take the drill bit that they sent me. This number 7 is what it is. And I'm going to line that up as straight as possible and drill through. If I'm off a little bit, as long as it's not an extreme amount, it just won't matter. So using a drill press or something like that just isn't required. We don't need that high level of precision. Eyeball that, get it as close as you can, and that will be good enough. So now we're going to drill the hole. We line that up with our pocket, and this is a large primer pocket, so it actually fits and creates kind of a guide for me. If I've got a small primer pocket, you know, I've got to work a little bit harder to keep that centered up, but it's actually pretty straightforward. You know, fairly low speed here, there's no reason. It's very soft metal, and that hard bite that caused that is the last little bit of brass that I needed to get out of there. Okay, so my hole's made. Now I'm going with my tap. The tap in the kit is 1/4 inch by 20. It's a pretty standard die. If I've got my own tap and die kit, I can use that bit and the handle that comes with it. I'm assuming you don't, so we'll use the kit that, you know, what they sent me. And in that case, that's smaller than 1/4 inch, which is usually the smallest combination wrench you have in your set, unless you've got some machinist tools. So I'm going to use an adjustable wrench here and just very carefully try to hold that straight. About every full turn or so that I make, I am going to want to back that off just enough to break those chips out of there.
All right. Once I'm through, I can feel those threads start to, you know, they just feel like a tight wrench, a tight bolt, like I'm threading in a tight bolt. I'm going to work that just a little bit to loosen those, that gap between those threads up a little bit, pull some of those shavings out of there, and just work that for just a second. And you can see how a drill would actually be pretty handy right here, as long as I didn't destroy those threads. And now I can see I've got a substantial amount of brass. That head has, you know, a solid piece of brass from the top of my tip to well past, you know, that last bit of the rim. That's pretty substantial. So I should now be able to thread in the bolt that they sent me with the kit. Obviously, this is a quarter inch, so I could use a regular quarter inch bolt if I've got the tap and die. All I need is a bolt similar size with a matching tap, but I need this spacer. And what this tool is basically just a way for my bolt to push down and cause the force to be on the threads pulling that up. So with that idea, I could use a socket. I have used that. I'm demonstrating the use of this kit, but I have used a socket, a quarter inch bolt that I have with a large washer on there. I add a little oil to the washer to make it slide nice and smooth. That does actually work fairly well. But I am showing you the kit today. So what we're going to do is just thread our bolt all the way down. And this is the spot where I may run out of space. I can feel that I'm hitting something. What do you suppose that is? Well, that's gonna be the decap pin, right? So I'm either gonna push the expander out of the neck of the case, or I'm gonna start damaging that decap pin. We don't know which, and we won't know until we get this all the way out. Now, this is gonna be tight. This is where I'm actually freeing the case that is stuck. All that force is going into trying to free that case. Now, I'm showing using the tool that came with the kit, and it's, you know, obviously doable. It is a little bit on the hard with a little longer handle. Might make this a little easier. All right, could I chuck this into a drill? Yeah, I would, but I wouldn't recommend it. You see how slow I'm wanting to go here. How about a socket? Yeah, socket would work. I want to keep it centered, of course, but I just need more leverage. Well, now I can feel it starting to go. As it's starting to come up, it's getting much easier. It's really that initial breaking that loose, initially is where my true force is required. All right, so we're getting somewhere now. There it is. All right, so my case comes out, and I still have the tool attached to the case. So the good news is my die is ready, but I do need, you know, the case is shot. I got to throw that away. I do need to get this out, and in this case, look at that. It just unthreads, and there you go. All right, now my particular press is not long enough to pull out the die without screwing the pin up. So I'm going to go ahead and take the pin up so that I can get the die out. And I can see I did, in fact, destroy that pin. All right, yeah, I can see that pin is shot. So when I'm ordering my kit, obviously, it's not a bad idea to go ahead and order a new pin. And the other thing you'll notice, I did get some brass shavings out of my die when I pulled this out. So even if your pin is okay, be sure to take this apart and go ahead and clean those shavings out. If you don't, and there's a small shaving stuck in the wall of my sizing die, it is going to dig into my case and leave a run in my case and possibly damage my die. So I do want to just blast that out with some air or, you know, brake cleaner or whatever you're using. You know, something probably compressed though, just to get down in there, run a patch or two through here, and just be sure I get all those shavings, you know, from the drilling process out of there. And I'm going to have to replace the pin, right? But the neck expander is fine. You know, the extractor is straight. All of this looks good other than the pin, which is a disposable part if I've got a threaded sizing die. So that's, you know, that's just fine.
Final thoughts on this process here. So just a couple points to think about. You know, one, could I use a socket? Well, I've picked up a socket for this particular cartridge. And the big difference here is there's a recess in the tool that lets that sit very flush and keeps it there, you know, very centered. My socket will fit. It's just a little wobbly. So I'm going to have to be particular about starting that. The hole on a 1/4-inch drive is pretty similar. So if I do have a socket, I really want to go with 1/4-inch. If I go with 3/8, the hole's going to be larger. Just need a washer, you know, pretty stout washer, maybe 2 or 3. That's point number one. Now, point number two, the bolt that came with the RCBS kit is designed to fit a number of different length cartridges. The cartridges we're using today are very similar to 308. This isn't a 308, but it's really, really close to that. And if we look at that and we look at our decap pin, where my expander hits the mouth of that case is as far as I'm going to be able to get this out. Because remember, it's stuck in there. So when I screw that down, you can see the tip of that expander of my decap pin, that's as low as it's going to go. It's not going to go any lower. If my case was longer, 30-06, 300 Win, something like that, probably would have cleared that pin with this bolt. Anything shorter, and I'm definitely going to make contact with the pin. What's the takeaway there? Well, I could either shorten this bolt a little bit before I start, find a different bolt that's, you know, threaded the same, just a little bit shorter, or add some washers on top of this, particularly if I'm going with a socket that's a little longer. You know, I can make that a little bit shorter so that I don't smash my decap pin, right? One of the things I may want to do when I'm ordering the kit is go ahead and order that decap pin, because there's a strong possibility, you know, better than 50-50, I'd say, that I'm going to damage that if I don't make some type of effort to prevent that. All right, so this is method number two removing a stuck case. I've shown you how to create your own, you know, using the socket idea or using the kit for the type die that has that threaded expander. The first video I did was on the Lee system using the Lee die itself. Will this work on that? Yeah, actually it will. I find tapping out the extractor is easier, but this will do it. If you have one kit, it will cover both of these dies. The third die that I'll do is the competition series RCBS, which this kit doesn't work very well for. And there's another kit that's actually simpler to use, doesn't require drilling and tapping. And I'll cover that at some point. If you have used this or have another idea about this, I'd love to hear it. Please give me a comment about that. I will respond. And as always, you know, mash that subscribe button if you would, please, and hit like if you would. Old Man Taylor coming to you from the reloading bench.